Our next topic is the parts of the brain from chapter 1, the nervous system. The largest and most complicated part of the human brain is the cerebrum. It receives information from all the sense organs and uses it to control your actions, behavior and speech. The cerebrum is also the part of the brain you use for thinking, remembering things, solving problems and making decisions. The cerebrum has two halves called cerebral hemispheres, linked by bundles of nerve fibers. Sensations from one side of the body connect to the opposite side of the cerebrum, and movements of one side of the body are controlled by the other side of the cerebrum. The right side of the cerebrum is the most important in artistic and creative tasks, while the left controls understanding, reading and thinking. This diagram shows the different parts of the brain: spinal cord, medulla oblongata, cerebrum and cerebellum. Below the cerebrum are the cerebellum and the medulla oblongata. The cerebellum keeps the body balanced and coordinates the muscle during walking, running, cycling and other activities. The medulla oblongata controls the breathing and heartbeat rate and maintains the pressure of the blood and the body temperature. The brain stem close to the spinal cord controls the body's automatic activities such as breathing and digestion. The brain needs a great deal of energy to do its work, although it only weighs about 5% of the body of the weight of the whole body. The brain uses about 1/5 of all the energy the body produces. Without oxygen, brain cells are quickly damaged and are unable to repair themselves. After about 5 minutes without oxygen, the whole brain is dead. The topic which we have studied is the parts of the brain, and it explains the different parts of the brain and what are their functions. Most complicated and largest part is cerebrum. Cerebrum has two halves or two parts called cerebral hemispheres. So the student should read this part very carefully and understand what are the function of cerebrum, medulla oblongata, spinal cord and cerebrum. Our topic is nerve cells from chapter 1, the nervous system. Nerve cells carry impulses in one direction only. Impulses travel from sense organs such as eye, ear and skin into the central nervous system, the brain and the spinal cord, along sensory nerve cells. Impulses then travel along connecting nerve cells to motor nerve cells, which carry them to muscles. A reflex action is a simple example of nerve cells in action. Its diagram is shown on page 6. Impulses are basically a sudden desire to act. So it explains that the direction of nerve cells is only one, and impulses travel from sense organ to central nervous system along the sensory nerve cells.